Controlled plane landings and water are known in the industry as ditching. These are rare occurrences, as are crash landings and water. However, landing in water is a scenario that pilots and crew must train for. Let's find out what happens when an airplane lands in water. Some years ago, when Captain Chelsea B. Sullenberger, or Sully, landed US Airways Flight 1549 into the Hudson River, the lack of fatalities and responsiveness of crew was hailed as a miracle. In the case of the miracle on the Hudson, the two pilots were able to land the A320 aircraft in just 6 minutes from the moment a flock of birds struck the engines. Where possible, pilots must try to prepare for their emergency water landing with the following taken into consideration. Air vents should be shut to prevent water seeping in. The UK Civil Aviation Authority also recommends that pilots land aircraft tail down. This will avoid a high impact on the nose of the aircraft and potentially allow for better flotation. It's also best that aircraft land with their wings level and in a section of water that's not too rough. When landing in the ocean, pilots should land parallel to waves to avoid rougher movements of the water. While all the technical aspects of the water landing are taking place, a mayday signal should also be emitted. In the case of Ethiopian Airlines Flight 961 in 1996, hijackers attempt to force control over the aircraft. The result was the pilots making a ditching attempt in the Indian Ocean near the Comoros Islands during negotiation with the attackers. Despite good intentions to land parallel with the waves, the aircraft banked left, causing the left wing to strike the ocean first. The result was unplanned contact with a coral reef, which caused the Boeing 767 to break as it entered the water. In this situation, various parts of the fuselage sank rapidly. The crew could not carry out emergency procedures quickly enough. Of the 175 passengers and crew members, 125 were killed, including the three hijackers. In the case of a stable landing on water, passengers and staff are then evacuated. There's no single figure which dictates how much time crews have before the aircraft sinks, but the structure of the plane will, in most cases, allow enough time. Aircraft evacuation slides double as life rafts, mitigating the chance of hypothermia while awaiting rescue. Once passengers and crew are evacuated, the closest suitable emergency crews will respond to their distress signal. Very often, hospitalization will be required for some passengers and crew. It's a little-known fact that despite no fatalities on the Hudson River, 100 out of the 155 passengers were injured to some degree. So what happens to an empty aircraft after landing on water? Well, the Airbus A320-200 that landed on the Hudson was lifted from the river with giant cranes and is now in a museum. However, when an aircraft breaks apart and rapidly sinks, the sections of the fuselage may not be recovered depending on the depth of the water. However, recovery equipment or divers will likely be sent to find the wreckage to examine it for fatalities and collect evidence for the investigation. You may not think that returning personal belongings from a water crash is that worthwhile. After all, waterlogged belongings are likely to be severely damaged. However, salvaging possessions does happen. It can be a sentimental thing for the families who've lost their loved ones in the crash. In the US Airways ditch on the Hudson River, clothing, medallions, and car keys were returned, and they were all said to be in reasonably good condition. If you have a video topic idea, leave it in the comments below, and maybe we'll make a video on it in the future. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.